ya!
Yo, what up guys, Nathan here, bringing you yet another Team Fortress 2 video, and in this commentary I will be talking about the Liberty Launcher and why it is overrated. So for you noobs out there who don't know the Liberty Launcher stats, it has a plus 40% faster projectile speed and a minus 25% rocket capacity, which basically means that it can hold one less rocket, and obviously the rockets that you do shoot will be going quite a bit faster. So let's get right into it. I just don't believe that this rocket launcher should be used as much as it is, because honestly, it's just not that good, and it's a lot worse than people think it is. I would say maybe one in every soldiers that I come into contact with are using the rocket launcher, and I just straight up believe that the projectile speed is definitely not worth the lost rocket. Also, for future reference, I will be comparing the Liberty Launcher to the default rocket launcher, so if I just kind of make references, then know that I'm referencing the default rocket launcher, but let's actually do that right now. So if you compare the Liberty Launcher to the default rocket launcher, you're losing one rocket, and like the damage is the same and everything, but what you're losing is actually an extra 50 to 100 damage with this launcher, and by that I mean you are missing out on a possible direct hit on an enemy or splash damage by firing, or by not firing that extra rocket that you could be using with the default rocket launcher. And the Liberty Launcher's rocket speed doesn't really come in that handy, because the only situation where it might really, really benefit you is in very, very long distances, where if you see an enemy, you want the rocket to get there as fast as possible while still having that splash damage. However, soldiers, in my opinion, are, well, not really in my opinion, but like, from experience, soldiers are usually mid to short range classes. They're not like super long range like the sniper. And honestly, mid to short range just works out very, very well for the soldier, since he has that splash damage, and he can be really effective. For example, I'm sure all of you out there have had instances where like a scout is just in the same room with you. The room is probably like 5 by 5 feet wide, so you just fire a rocket at your feet maybe twice and you just kill the scout. I mean, it just works out like that. The soldier's very, very good for short range. But by contrast, it seems as if the Liberty Launcher is made for long range, when the soldier isn't just really long range. And in terms of projectile speed, the Liberty Launcher is really iffy, because it's very in between the default rocket launcher speed and then the direct hit speed. So if we talk about the direct hit here for a second, the direct hit rocket speed is like just awesome in terms of its projectile speed, because if you want to hit somebody in close quarters, it is just there, it's on them, it's doing that whatever damage it does, like 125 or something like that, if you get a direct hit on them. But if you're in close quarters, you're sacrificing an extra 100, like 50 to 100 damage, depending on if you get a direct hit on them, for projectile speed that you don't even need in a close quarters situation. And that is really why the projectile speed doesn't really matter for soldier, unless you're going for those direct hits on players. Like the direct hit has the fast enough projectile speed where it's just rocket onto player to get that super amount of damage. So next we'll talk about kill times. So if I'm firing my default rocket launcher at heavy, let's say, and I'm not getting any direct hits, I'm just doing splash damage, it's landing like 2 feet away from him, so I'm getting maybe 60 damage on the heavy, and he's got 300 health, so therefore we can assume that it'll take 5 rockets to take out this heavy, being 300 divided by 60 equals 5. So if I fire at him and he's shooting at me with my default rocket launcher, and let's say I'm undercover, so I'm not just gonna die right away, because everybody knows if you're in a CQC situation with a heavy, you are just so screwed. But anyway, okay, so let's say I'm firing at him with the default rocket launcher. Let's say it'll take 4 seconds to fire all 4 of my rockets into him, assuming each rocket will take a second, and let's assume that it'll take a second to reload. So that means to fire 5 rockets, it'll take 4 rockets, reload, and then another rocket, so that would equal 6 seconds to take out this heavy. If we instead use the Liberty Launcher, it will take 3 seconds to fire my 3 rockets, you have to reload, so that's another second, fire another rocket, reload, and then fire another rocket, which will take 7 seconds, and that is one extra second that the heavy will be able to do damage on you. And the kill times, like, it may not sound that much longer, like 1 second being exposed to this heavy while it's firing at you, but if you look at that mathematically, that is 1/6 less time it would take to kill that heavy, which means that the default rocket launcher launcher would basically be doing 17% more damage than the Liberty launcher when you're not even utilizing its pro, which is the projectile speed. So let's say, let's actually put it in an environment where you can utilize the pro, which is the projectile speed. So if you're firing, okay, so let's imagine PL Badwater, the map I'm playing on right now. If you're firing from the rock outcropping, if you guys know what I'm talking about, near the very first blue spawn, if you walk forward and then go up the hill, near the first cap point for the cart, if you're firing near that rock outcropping to those cement barriers where a lot of snipers snipe from, if you fire, let's say, 3 rockets from there to the concrete barriers where a heavy is just standing there firing at you, and you fire your 3 rockets, my bet would be that the heavy would be able to see them incoming and be able to move left or right to dodge them, to minimize the splash damage or whatever may result with that. But if you then compare the default rocket launcher, even though you have an extra rocket, the effect is still going to be the same. Even though you have an extra rocket, he's still going to be able to see them incoming and be able to dodge them. And like, that's the exact point, is that even though the default rocket launcher may be somewhat worse in this situation because it doesn't have that projectile speed, there's still the same effect. Like the Liberty launcher didn't help at all because the heavy was still able to dodge them. And I'm assuming that this imaginary heavy that we're talking about pretty much has like the same skill level as me, like he's not just a total noob and knows how to dodge away from stuff. So now let's compare the Liberty launcher to the Black Box, being they both have the same con, losing that 4th rocket. So with the Black Box, you gain 15 health per person that you hit, be that splash damage or direct hit. And what's great about it is that you can gain more than 15 health from one rocket. So if you hit like a group of 3 enemies and they all get hit with splash damage, you will be gaining 45 health from just that one rocket. So that is a much, much greater pro to me, because you are like literally just spawning health packs for yourself. Like, that's why the sandwich is so great for heavy, is that it's literally like portable health, and that's what the Black Box is. I mean, you just keep on gaining health for however much damage you deal out. Now back with the Liberty launcher, once again, instead of like gaining that health, you're just gaining quote-unquote accuracy by the projectile speed, which in my opinion, that just isn't existent. And we are nearing the end of the video here. That's kind of my rant on the Liberty launcher. So anyway, if you guys like the video, please leave a rating. I really appreciate it. It takes less than a second. And you are awesome and sexy for doing so. But if you enjoy TF2, feel free to subscribe, because I bring that. And sorry, probably not Minecraft anytime soon. I'm not really... you know, Minecraft kind of goes in, like, spurts for me, like, just like every other video game. Like, right now I'm sort of in the TF2 / Call of Duty spurt, where I play a lot of that, but, Minecraft will come back eventually. I'll eventually bring more of that. So, if you subscribe for Minecraft specifically, then I'm sorry, but, it will be a while, until that gets running on my channel again. But anyway, once again, I'll just bring you guys some more TF2. I got more videos planned, so, yeah. I'll see you guys later. Peace out.